You might think that tornado tracking looks a little something like this. And actually, it sort of does.
Currently, the state of the art in tornado detection is eyesight. And the weather services train up what they call spotters, who if they see a funnel hits the ground, they get on their phone and call it in.
Twisters are incredibly dangerous forces of nature, and they can barrel into towns with little to no warning. And unreliable predictions can often cause alarms to be ignored. But at the National Center of Acoustics, a team of audio specialists are searching for a faster, more reliable, and safer way to warn people in tornado-heavy areas. And the solution isn't what you'd expect.
This is the type of sensor that was designed primarily for the nuclear weapon test ban treaty.
This is Just Might Work, a show about surprising solutions to our biggest problems. Every year in the United States, tornadoes cause about $400 million in damage and kill around 70 people. Despite their destructive force, the people in their path typically receive only about a 10-minute warning. This is all in part because tornado prediction is really unreliable. Currently, meteorologists are only able to use radar to identify the kinds of conditions that tornadoes might exist in.
They can pick out hot spots that might be tornadoes, but that's not what they depend on for actual detection.
7 out of 10 tornado warnings are false alarms. This means that people who live in Tornado Alley are used to hearing, and even ignoring, a lot of sirens. To make things even more unpredictable, experts speculate that changes in the climate are actually shifting the boundaries of Tornado Alley into new areas of the country. All these forces at play are making the need for a better tornado warning system more and more urgent.
All right, how's my hair? Is it still gray?
Roger Waxler is not a meteorologist.
We don't have meteorologists in this group. We're at best amateurs when it comes to meteorology.
Then if you look at these oscillations,
my background is in quantum field theory. And our specialty in our group is really just detection and phenomenology of infrasound propagation in the atmosphere. I tend to overexplain, so stop me if I'm doing such.
In simpler terms, Waxler and his team study acoustics, and they can listen to all sorts of things the human ear can't.
That's right, that's better. Elephants communicate in an infrasonic band, actually. Volcanoes produce infrasound when they're active. The aurora borealis produces an infrasound signal. Meteors that explode in the atmosphere, lightning.
But Waxler's team wasn't pulled together to listen to any of those things. They came together to listen for nuclear bombs. In the 1990s, more than 30 countries signed on to the Comprehensive Nuclear Test Ban Treaty, meant to put a halt to any sort of testing on nuclear bombs. And they commissioned these sensor arrays to listen for the infrasonic signatures of nukes.
The explosion that the Israelis set off was detected infrasonically as far away as Mongolia, which is about 6,000 kilometers away. This was validation of the sensor technology. This is one of the sensors that we make in-house. We have it underneath this dome to protect from wind noise. And this is the type of sensor that was designed primarily for the nuclear weapon test ban treaty. But then we found we can use it well for many other things. So it was pointed out back in the 60s that tornadoes emit infrasound. We were skeptical, but we had the funding, and so we dutifully went out and set out arrays of microphones in Oklahoma and captured signals from tornadoes that were spot on. We realized the way to go was to put out arrays and leave them in the region for the entire season.
Ever since Waxler and his team have been tracking tornadoes through acoustics, they've never had a false alarm or had a single twister slip under their radar.
The very smallest tornadoes we've detected from 80 kilometers. I don't think the size matters.
As long as the winds, which is what all this is about, are blowing in the right direction, we can hear the tornado from 50 to 100 kilometers away in almost every case.
This means that if we could place these sensors across areas where tornadoes are prevalent, we could know with certainty when and where tornadoes form and issue advanced warnings, all through a remote, always-on system. For Roger and his team, the next step is to investigate whether they can use sound to know if a tornado is forming before it even touches down.
It's a question in our minds whether we pick it up before it hits the ground or not. If there was a signal produced when the vortex forms, which we could pick up, that would be ideal.
Pretty much wraps it up.
With so many false warnings, lack of trust in those warnings, and crude measurement of where tornadoes are located at any given moment, the stakes for finding a better tornado warning system are high. And while it's uncertain how exactly changes in the climate will affect tornado season, early research indicates the tornadoes of the future might be less frequent, but more powerful, and that they can show up in new places.
Tornadoes terrify this part of the world, and people die. What happened with us was we were pursuing this technology more or less by accident. We have the expertise in infrasound detection. We found it worked and realized that we could potentially save lives.
Thanks for watching. For more stories about surprising solutions to our biggest problems, subscribe and check out our story about how a robot dolphin could be the answer to ending animal captivity.